Hey everyone, welcome to my channel. My name is Benji and I design and build open source synthesizer modules. Almost 3 years ago, I designed and released my first PCB-based synthesizer module. It's an oscillator based on Moritz Klein's tutorials. I've been using it a lot and since then, I've realized I wanted to add more features to it. In my last video, I talked about using the Deadbug method for prototyping new modules. In this one, I thought it'd be a good time to talk about how I use the Deadbug method to add more features to an existing module. In my old module, you had a knob that controlled pulse width. However, you had no way to control it using CV. The range of the pulse width knob wasn't that good either, so I wanted to change that in this new version. The saw wave and pulse outputs work great, but I wanted to have something smoother like a triangle wave. So that's what we'll do now. First part of the process, of course, was to look for resources that I could use. Since then, Moritz released an update to his circuit that added a PWM input. So I added this to my notes. I also found this simple circuit that turned a saw wave into a triangle wave. So I also added that to my references. Next step was to rebuild the entire circuit on a breadboard. But of course, to make it easy for myself and to give myself some sort of a blueprint to follow, I decided to draw all my plan changes on KiCad. Just for reference, this is how my circuit looked before the changes and after. You can break down the changes into two sections. First is the pulse section, which included this PWM CV input, as well as a new triangle wave section. Both of these sections just tap into the sawtooth wave output. This will be important later when you do our mods. Also take note that even though the old one had a pulse output, we will have to build a new pulse section to accommodate the changes. After I'm finished with my schematics, I started building it on a breadboard and then test it there. I make sure to play with it while it's on breadboard. I also made sure that for each change that I did on breadboard, I also update my drawings. Once I'm happy with the breadboarded circuit, I started to design a panel for the extra controls using my Europanel Maker library on OpenSCAD. This meant that I had to make a panel that would accommodate the jacks such as the pulse out, PWM CV, triangle out, as well as the knobs for pulse width and PWM amount. I printed the panel out using my 3D printer. Now it's time to move on to the actual Deadbug build. But before that, let me talk about the sponsor of this video, PCBWay. I love using the Deadbug method for one-offs and prototypes. But when I finally want to make my build more reliable and repeatable, I design a PCB for it. This is where PCBWay comes in. I design my layout on KiCad, export my files, upload the Gerber files onto PCBWay's website, and then wait for my Eurorack module to arrive. In fact, the Mini OSC was my first collaboration with PCBWay, and it's the very first Eurorack PCB-based module that I've released. You can order the Mini OSC through PCBWay's website. I'll add a link in the description. I'll also probably make a version 2 for this soon. Thank you, PCBWay, for always supporting my projects. Now, let's get back to the build. Unfortunately, I don't have any footage for when I built this one, but let's still talk about it. Just like with my other Deadbug build, I started by soldering on the ground connections. Fortunately, I had access to the Eurorack power sockets, which had a lot of ground connections, so I also take advantage of that to hold my Deadbug circuit in place. I also use the ground lugs on the jacks to help hold the circuit in place. After soldering the ground connections, my 3D printed panel is basically coupled together with my Eurorack module. From there, it was only a matter of building the new sections using my Deadbug method. It's a good idea to build the circuits section by section. So here I have the new PWM circuit. You can also see it here on the panel. Here at the bottom, you can also see the new triangle wave section. For power connections, I used 24 AWG wires. You might find it weird, but you can actually solder wires onto the PCB pads if you have to tap on something. Here, I had to add some connections to the... These are the positive and negative 12 volts. The two sections will also have to connect to C12. All I had to do was connect a piece of wire onto the capacitor lead. Now my module is ready for testing. I mounted my new module onto the case. Because my 3D printed section was basically an independent Eurorack panel, I didn't have any trouble mounting it to my case. I hope this little peek at my process was interesting and helpful. If you'd like to support my open source projects, please consider donating through my Ko-fi account. I'll add the link in the description. That would be all for now. Thank you very much for watching and I hope to see you again in the next video. Thank you.